South Africa got its independence in 1994. We had our first democratic election. Kazakhstan, of course, you know, got its independence 23 years ago. And it was time for both parties to engage in building diplomatic relations. The South African government identified Kazakhstan as a strategic partner in Central Asia. So we opened an embassy way back in 2003. And that was because our foreign affairs identified Kazakhstan as the entry point to Eurasia and Central Asia. Kazakhstan responded favorably by identifying South Africa as a strategic partner and a gateway into Africa. And the government of the Republic of Kazakhstan opened a diplomatic mission in South Africa in 2013, last year. So both countries now have full diplomatic missions, ambassadors who have presented credentials, and fully functional embassies. That's a very big achievement. The government of Kazakhstan has also opened a mission in Addis Ababa. Now, this is very important because for us in Africa, we pay a lot of emphasis on the African Union. So the ambassador accredited to Addis Ababa will also participate as an observer in the African Union. So this brings the two continents, Central Asia and Africa, much closer. Look, I sincerely admire the progress that Kazakhstan has made as a government and as a nation. So let us look at some of the things that strike me. Firstly, you have built a new capital in a short space of 17 years. I don't think this has been achieved anywhere else in the world. Astana, in my view, is a city that every person involved in town planning, architecture, construction should visit as a case study. You've laid out a wonderful skyline with very attractive buildings and in a very short space of time. It is both beautiful and functional. So that's one major achievement. I've been around Kazakhstan to many areas and I see that the cities are developing in equal proportion. So that is another big compliment. It's not only happening in one hub. Moreover, if you look at the social aspects, if you look at education, you look at healthcare, if you take social benefits, there have been great improvements. So of course that directly impacts on the life of Kazakhstani citizens. When you look at the income, per capita income, your individual income has grown multifold. So people of Kazakhstan have money to enjoy a better quality of life. And moreover, you have done this very carefully by building a national sovereign fund. So as you know, recently President Nazarbayev has announced that funds from your savings can be used to weather the hard storm that he predicts coming ahead. So you have the savings, and that's a remarkable achievement. There are many factors that we admire Kazakhstan for. The Kazakhstan Strategy 2050 is another remarkable area. You know, we in South Africa have National Development Plan 2030. I've studied both documents, and there are a lot of similarities, a lot of opportunities for participation. But yes, that is something that is worth commenting on, and your roadmap has been laid out, your targets to be one of the 30 most developed countries is set. So the entire government machinery and people are moving towards it. Of course, Kazakhstan has made major strides in renewable energy. You have succeeded in securing Expo 2017. We are observing the developments within Expo 2017. And you, in the short to medium term, you've cut out the work that you need to do. very clearly in infrastructure development and so forth. The emphasis on the new Silk Road, the rail road development is something that Kazakhstan has seriously achieved with a lot of focus and intention. So yes, the country has done well on a lot of fronts. People are benefiting, the government is getting stronger. Internationally, most countries are starting to focus on Kazakhstan as the key hub in this region. So you have a lot to celebrate for your democracy, and we wish you well. Firstly, let us wish everyone good health, prosperity. We wish that all Kazakhstan citizens travel to interesting places, meet interesting people, and do interesting things. But moreover, you know, I have said repeatedly, and I coined this phrase from the second or third day that I came to Kazakhstan, and I felt the pulse of the development in Kazakhstan. I said that President Nursultan Nazarbayev is following on the footsteps of Mahatma Gandhi, Martin Luther King, and Nelson Mandela. So my biggest wish to Kazakhstan is that your president has long life, has good health, and is able to work in the interest of the people of Kazakhstan for a longer period. I wish the government well. You have a good captain on a good ship, and his lieutenants on the ship are also very able, very capable. So we wish all the departments that we are working with the very best, and of course the people of Kazakhstan.